Welcome back to my YouTube channel, breathtakingly gripping and amazingly logical, although rather hard and challenging, here comes ending R. There are lots of endings that have R at the end. If you are in love with German, as is the case with me, you can look at all of these endings separately. If not, you can just remember that if a word finishes in R, it's primarily masculine, with no more exceptions than usually, 10 to be exact. But this ending encompasses thousands of words, and if you become familiar with those 10 exceptions, I'll give a variant of how to do this, you won't have to learn thousands of words with their gender. Here is the table with all the exceptions so that you don't switch this video off thinking that you'll never be able to learn so many exceptions. In this video, I'm going to speak about each of these endings separately. Good news! The endings ler, ner, iker, janer, aner, ö are the easiest. They are officially recognized and don't have any exceptions at all. The hardest ending is er. There is a very useful tip how to learn hundreds of words that end in er without having to learn anything. In order to use this tip, one has to know if er is a suffix or an ending. If it's a suffix, the word can be only masculine, without exceptions. If it's an ending, the majority of words will be still masculine, although there is and always will be new feminine and neuter words with this ending, which we will be learning with the help of a dictionary. How to know if er is a suffix? If you can understand or guess the meaning of the word without er, it's a suffix. If not, it's an ending. For example, if you hear a word Wolkenkratzer, can you guess its meaning? Of course, it's something that scratches the sky, the clouds. So it's a skyscraper. So er is a suffix in this case. And the word is definitely masculine. The word Lockenwickler is also very easy to guess. It's something that makes your hair curly. Or the word Speicher, it's something that is used to store something, a storage device, memory unit. This word comes from a verb with a lost ending en. That's why we can see that before it became a noun, it was a verb. If a verb loses its ending, it's going to be almost always masculine. But it's another story. The main thing here is that we can guess its meaning. So er here is a suffix. The same goes for all the words that are represented in this table. Der Leiter is someone who leads something, a firm for example. This word is of course masculine, because er is a suffix here. But we have another word that sounds exactly the same, but it has a different meaning. And these two words have to be separated from each other so that we don't mix them up. And this goal is achieved by giving a feminine gender to the word die Leiter. If er is an ending, there are some words that are exceptions. It est, they are not masculine. We can remember some of these exceptions using our logic, because they are not real exceptions. Die Mutter and die Tochter don't have to be remembered with their gender. They can be only feminine. All the snakes are feminine, so they don't have to be remembered separately. Die Kiefer is feminine, like the majority of the trees that don't have any strong masculine endings. And there is one more reason why this word is feminine. It's the same like with the words der Leiter and die Leiter. Der Kiefer means a part of the body, a jaw. In order not to mix a jaw up with a pine tree, these words have to be separated with the help of a different gender. There are trees that end in der or ster. They are all masculine except for the word die Zeder. So die Zeder is a real exception. The word die Auster belongs to feminine words because of its meaning, as is the case with the word die Nummer. Die Nummer, die Zeit, die Zahl, die Ziffer, die Zukunft, die Gegenwart, die Vergangenheit. Die Metapher can be only feminine, as are all syntactical figures. the words die Mauer, die Schulter, die Oder und die Folter, I count in the strong words group. Die Wand and die Mauer are things that can protect, and it would be logical if these words were masculine. But no matter how illogical and astonishing it sounds, these words are feminine, like all the words in the strong group. The words die Wimper and die Feder are adornments, decorations, ornaments, embellishments, and are that's why feminine, together with the word die Zier. In case of the ending er, we have to remember just these feminine real exceptions. Die Zeder, die Faser, die Ader, die Kammer, because they are real exceptions. If you've got any suggestions how we could learn these four words with their gender, please let me know in the comments below. Das Alter is a substantivized adjective, which are 100% neutral. Das Wasser has neutral gender, because it's the initial form of a beverage, so to speak. Die Coca-Cola is feminine and neuter. I prefer feminine gender, because it has the ending a. Das Bier is neuter, because it has the form two vocals plus r. We'll speak about this further today. Das Futter and das Wetter are collective terms, which are all 100% neuter. Das Pulver belongs to mosaic words, which are all neuter. Das Center, das Kaufhaus, das Einkaufszentrum are all neuter. We can use the story method with all the remaining neuter exceptions. Auf dem Cover eines Magazins, das ich während des Dinners gelesen habe, ist ein Lager gemalt am Ufer. Es gibt ein Zimmer in dem Lager, es liegt ein Opfer in diesem Zimmer, mit einem Messer in der Hand. Es war ein schreckliches Massaker da. Das Manöver des Täters funktionierte nicht. Er sitzt hinter dem Gitter jetzt. Das Meer is a collective term. The ending Eier is also masculine. The not real exceptions are die Leier and die Feier. Die Feier has many synonyms that are all feminine. That's why I see them all as a group of joy words, and that's why die Feier is a not real exception for me. Die Leier can be only feminine, because all of the three musical instruments that end in er are feminine. The ending er is also masculine. The feminine not real exception is the word die Mär. Die Mär and die Geschichte are both feminine, so it's not a real exception. The neuter exception is the word das Militär, so that we don't mix this word up with der Militär. Das Militär is also a mosaic word, which are all neutral. The ending OR is also masculine. The exceptions are das Tor. Das Tor is neuter, so that we don't mix it up with der Tor. AR is also a masculine ending. The feminine exceptions can be counted into strong words group with the help of a little horror story, which begins with the words die Schar, die Bar. The not real neuter exceptions are the words das Bar can be only neuter because it's a measurement unit. Das Formular, das Exemplar, das Vokabular, das Glossar belong to book words and to modal words. Das Inventar and das Mobiliar are mosaic words, and that's why can be only neuter. And the real exceptions are das Honorar, das Seminar and das Gar. The endings EHR, UHR, AHR, UR are feminine. The masculine exception is a word der Verkehr, which has three meanings. Der Verkehr has nothing to do with the words die Umkehr, die Rückkehr or die Wiederkehr, which have all approximately the same meaning. So the word der Verkehr had to be separated from other words, which was done with the help of a gender. Das Gewehr has prefix ge and is therefore neuter. Der Vorfahr can be only masculine because of its meaning. Das Jahrtausend, das Jahrhundert, das Jahr, das Quartal and das Semester are all neuter. Beginning with der Monat, the words are masculine, der Monat, der Tag. Beginning with die Stunde, everything is feminine, die Stunde, die Minute, die Sekunde, die Millisekunde, etc. Der Aufruhr has to be masculine so that we don't mix this word up with the word der Ruhr. Der Flur and its synonyms are all masculine. Der Schwur belongs to mouth words, which are all of them masculine. Das Abitur is a sort of exam, which is also neuter. Das Futur is a grammatical term which are primarily neuter. The words that end in two vocals plus R are usually neuter. The words der Pionier, der Offizier, der Kavalier, der Stier, der Pier, der Tapir, der Mohair can be only masculine, as you know from my previous videos, so they are not real exceptions. Die Zier, as I mentioned in this video already, is feminine. Die Gier and die Manier are real exceptions. Die Steuer can be only feminine, so that we don't mix it up with das Steuer. And secondly, because this word goes into numbers, time, money, bank words. So you see that if a word finishes in R, it's primarily masculine. Thus, we have learned 20 endings. There are 22 endings in my method, so there are two left, L and T. They will be really hard. Up until this moment, you have seen that all the endings were easy or a little bit hard, but none of them had more than 12 exceptions. And I would like to draw your attention to the fact that this way we have learned already more than 2,000 of words with their gender, the words that do not have any grammatically recognized endings. And you see that there is a way to know the word's gender easier. There are not that many exceptions. I hope to see you in my next videos. So if you have liked this video, please like it, subscribe to my YouTube channel, write your comments below, and I wish you lots of success in learning German. Tschüss!